So having 20/20 vision sounds like an achievement, excellence, perfection, clarity, but it really doesn't mean any of those things. In fact, it's one of the most easily confused and misunderstood aspects of all of eye and vision care. And in this video, I'm going to be explaining 20/20 vision and what it really means. Let's take a look. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes and vision. And I'm really excited today to talk to you about 20/20 vision and what that actually means. Now, the last time you went in to have your eye exam, a vision check, a vision screening, a doctor, a nurse, or an ophthalmic technician likely started off testing your vision by you looking at a board or some sort of a chart on the wall about 20 feet away, asking you to read as far down as you possibly could. And that chart was likely a Snellen chart. And the Snellen chart was originally developed in 1862 by an ophthalmologist named Herman Snellen. Now, it's certainly not the only chart that's out there. It's maybe the most common, but we have a lot of different vision charts out there. We have the ETDRS chart we use for scientific studies. We've got cool shapes and different symbols that we use for little children. And we even have something like the tumbling E, which you've ever seen this. It's for people who can't otherwise tell us what letters they're seeing, or maybe they just can't read at all, maybe they just don't know the alphabet, but instead they can just hold up their fingers and tell us which way the E is pointing. Is it left? Is it right? Is it going up? Is it going down? There's a lot of creative ways to test people's vision. But as people read down this chart, getting to the smaller and smaller lines, you will start to see one of the smaller lines being the 20/20 letters. But did you notice how I didn't say that the 20/20 line was the very bottom? Yes, in fact, there are smaller letters that people can see, and some people do see better than 20/20. But when was the last time you had your vision checked? Were you seeing 20/20 better or worse? Let me know in the comments. 20/20 is known as what is called a Snellen fraction, which is the ability to see or identify a letter or some image of a certain height at a certain distance. And in fact, did you know that outside of the United States, it's not even called 20/20, it's called 6/6 due to the metric system, where 6 meters is roughly equivalent to 20 feet. Ultimately, the 20/20 or 6/6 describes the visual angle of an object or an image that enters into the eye. For example, if you are looking at a tree in the far distance and you walk toward that tree, the tree starts to look larger. And it's not that the tree actually grew larger in front of you right away, it's that the tree actually just starts to take up a larger visual angle inside of the eye and more of your visual field, and therefore it appears larger. Now, the textbook definition of 20/20 vision that I memorized when I was in optometry school was that 20/20 vision is when a person was able to identify a spatial pattern that subtends 5 minutes of arc at 20 feet. Wait, what? Again, 20/20 describes the visual angle, and at a 20-foot distance, the letter creates an angle of 5 minutes of arc. And if you already know what 5 minutes of arc means, then I am super impressed, because when I first heard this in optometry school, I had no idea what my professor was talking about. Basically, there's 360 degrees in a circle. Take one of those degrees, divide it by 60, and that gives you a minute of arc. And that's a very small angle. And the 20/20 letters subtend 5 minutes of arc. And all the letters on the 20/20 line are actually designed with that in mind, being that a letter E will have 3 arms, and each arm will contain 1 minute of arc, including the spaces between those arms, to give a total of 5 minutes of arc. But largely, 20/20 vision is what is known as a standard, or what is a common visual acuity that is obtained by the human eye and the entire visual system under normal development. Being that 20/20 is just what is common, or known as the standard, there are people who have vision above that standard and below that standard. In the clinic, we denote the acuity as 20 over another number, such as somebody who sees worse than 20/20, and they are seeing something like 20 over 40. In this case, the 20 on the top of the fraction describes the testing distance of you, the person that we are measuring, versus the lower number, which is describing the testing distance of a fictitious person with the 20/20 standard vision. And in this case, that person would be standing 40 feet away to just barely identify the 20/40 line, which is what you, the person with 20/40 vision, would be being able to read at 20 feet. So let's do one more example. If you were only able to see the 2200 letter, that's the largest letter E at the top of most Snellen charts, then that means that you at 20 feet could only see that large letter, and that would denote the 20 at the top of the fraction, where a person who has normal standard 20/20 vision would have to stand 200 feet away, 10 times the distance away, to just barely see that letter at the top of the chart. If you are somebody that could only read that 2200 letter even with corrective lenses, then you would technically qualify to have legal blindness according to the United States. But there's actually a lot more to legal blindness, and that's something for a whole other video. By the way, legal blindness, does anyone else think that sounds funny? If there's legal blindness, then what's illegal blindness? Let me know in the comments what you think illegal blindness would be. And as I said earlier, some people can see better than 20/20. In fact, a lot of people can. In this case, if someone was seeing 20/15, it would be compared to somebody as Mr. Jones' 20/20 vision could see only if he stepped forward 5 feet. The important message of this video is not to get hung up or anxious about seeing 20/20 every time you have your vision checked. It's really just a benchmark or a standard. And there are people who have worse than 20/20 vision, seeing 20/30, 20/40, walking around and are very happy and content with their vision. They're still able to do all the activities they want to do in their life and go where they need to go. The times when it is super important to be seeing 20/20 is whenever somebody is operating a motor vehicle, going to school, or if they're really young children. And that's because if you're not seeing well and operating a motor vehicle, you could be putting people's lives at danger. It's also been found that poor school performance is directly linked to poor visual acuity and reading skills. And young children who are not seeing very well, despite them not complaining about it, can actually not develop the proper neural connections within their brain to ever appreciate 20/20, and they could be permanently robbed of ever being able to see 20/20 in their lifetime. There's actually a medical term for that. It's called amblyopia, and we'll cover that in another video. So if you, a child, or another family member have not had their vision checked in a long time and not sure if you're seeing 20/20, call up your local eye care professional and schedule an exam. Tell them Dr. Eyehell sent you.